Hi, I'm Stephen Downs. In this video, I'm going to be following along step by step a how to do it page on a website. And what I'm up to with this video is to show not just how to do something, but to illustrate my thought process as I go through this. Now, it might work, it might not work, I don't know, but we'll give it a try. Okay, so here we go. Here's the article I've chosen. It's called A Simple Chat App with React, Node, and WebSocket. Node is a JavaScript framework. React is a framework that works within Node, and WebSocket is also a framework that works within Node. So Node is sort of the overall thing. So in this quick guide, we're told it's a 4-minute read. By Dan Kaufhold from BitLab Studio. So minimum code required to get a chat room up and running using React, Node, and WebSocket. So, okay. All right, so in the end, we'll have an app that looks something like this. All right, we have chat client in the left side, chat client in the right side. Okay, good. So let's see how this is done. First of all, prepare the back end. All right, I like that terminology, back end. It tells me it's going to be a back end. Okay. I'm not sure this is going to work. I don't have yarn. Well, let's see. Yarn isn't part of Node. Yarn is something completely. Why would he use yarn and add WS? Well, let's see how far we can get here. Okay, so in my project root directory, don't have a root directory yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up Windows PowerShell and some. Going to go into, I have a directory called code projects. I put it under the documents directory because I've learned from hard experience that if you put it somewhere else, which is nicer and cleaner, then if you run one of those scripts that erases everything except your files, it erases all your code projects. So I'll leave it under documents. Now I'll make a directory dear. We'll just call it, I don't know what to call it, BitLab. Call it BitLab. Sure. Alright, and let's cd into that directory. Okay. It's pretty small to see on the screen here, but I don't think I can make this bigger, can I? No, because it's PowerShell. Okay. Now, okay, so now we'll make the directory backend, mkdir backend, cd backend, okay, and then yarn add ws, and this will probably fail, and it failed. Why? Because we don't have yarn. We don't even know what yarn is. He hasn't mentioned this. Okay, so let's look up yarn. One thing, no. Fast, reliable, and secure directory management. Yeah, that's probably it. Yeah, stable for various versions of Node. Install yarn. Okay, so let's install yarn. Operating system, Windows. Download the installer. Save file. Now I'm just kind of like on a wing and a prayer here already. I'm like 3 lines in to this example and I'm on a wing and a prayer. But what can you do? So, all right, finish the exit to set up. install. Now, it probably still won't work, right? Usually to test something, you just type in the name of it and then version or hyphen V. Right, so it still doesn't know what it is yet. So the secret here is you close your PowerShell and then you open it up again. Now, if you're a novice, you might not know that, but okay. And of course, it always goes back to the same place. So CD, documents, code projects, BitLab, and then back end. All right, now we're back where we were. Let's go back to our chat app, yarn at WS. And there we go. So it's fetching some WS, whatever WS is. I assume WS is WebSockets. So I assume I've used Yarn to install something called WebSockets. Okay. Then we will need the actual server.js file, which is merely the following. Okay, it's merely the following. Anytime somebody says merely, it's probably a problem. Okay, so because, you know, they're them, it's simple. For me, not so much. Let's copy this code. Okay, and so we'll go back. Here's, this is the directory, but what we'll do here is I think I'll use a code editor. I use Visual Studio Pro, or sorry, Visual Studio Code. Here it is. So I'm going to open a folder. What folder? Well, probably the one we're in. So here's code projects, BitLab, backend. So I'll select this node modules. This must be what, there it is, WS. So yarn installed async limiter. I didn't ask IS a dependency in WS. So this is something that yarn installed for me. I don't see anything in it, but okay. Backend, so okay. Now, so we'll select this folder. Now that's old. We'll just ignore that. All right. So here we are. There's yarn lock, so it's locked something package JSON. So I know from previous experience that this file is used by node to indicate the dependencies. So what yarn has done is it's added these directories for me, but oh, and it has put stuff in them, and then it's also written into this package.json file. Okay, so back end, but now I want to create a file. So new file, and what was it called again? Server.js. So new file. There we go. Server.js. Alright, now I'm editing server.js. And here's the code that I copied from his page. So I just cut and paste it right in here, and now I'll hit Control S and that saves it. Alright, so he hasn't told us where to put this file, but I'm assuming it goes in this directory. I'm assuming. He hasn't even actually told us to make it, but okay. Okay, step two, add the front end. Optional, if you haven't already, install CRA. Now, yarn global add create React app. Now, something's going on here that he's not talking about. Yarn global, that means, I think, that I'm installing this not only for this particular application, but for all of my applications generally. And that's good. I mean, it means it's always available to me if I'm building something. But you have to be careful, right? If I've installed something globally, and then I go to write an application that needs that global thing, it'll work. But then if I take that very same code and try to run it on something that does not have that thing globally installed, it won't work. So you have to be a bit careful. But okay, let's just follow along here. So yarn global add create React app. So what I expect to happen, this is, you know, I don't want to work with these two terminals like this, so I'm going to close PowerShell. I don't need PowerShell anymore because Visual Studio Code has a built-in terminal, and here I am, and I'm right in this directory here. So, okay. So now I can just put my command in here, yarn global add create React app. I'll hit enter, and there we go. While yarn is doing this, it's locked some stuff, and once it's done, it'll unlock it. But you know, that's one of these things you need to sort of keep in mind. If you interrupt it halfway through, yarn might not unlock. So anyhow, and see, it's okay, we haven't added anything yet, yarn integrity, but it's coming. Okay, it's done. So let's look at what we've got here. All right, it's not going to be in here. Packets JSON. Right, so it hasn't changed any of that because it installed it globally. All right. So, anyhow, moving back to our application, our instructions. All right. Then back in your project root, you want to create a new React app. Now the project root, I assume, is the upper level directory. So let's come back here. So the project root is the directory BitLab, which is one directory up, and now you see we're in BitLab. So, okay, and then create React app front end. Is this a command? Okay, well, let's see if this works. Yeah, it looks like it's going to work. Okay, so yarn did, I don't know what, I guess create app. React app is, well, I'm not sure what it is. maybe it's a plugin or a utility. See, that's what happens a lot in these how-to articles. They just sort of slide by something that they think is relatively obvious. And it wasn't obvious to me. So while that's installing, let's try to figure out what happened here. I'm going to copy that, and this is really useful. I'm just going to search on that exact phrase. So, okay, yarn global spells. I guess yarn, typing yarn create yarn global is like typing npm I haven't used yarn before, so It'll add the packages named global and the package name. So this is installed somewhere else, but it can, and then it can be used in any of the node projects that I have. All right, so I don't know where it is. Oh, okay, so let's look at, now this is finished. So, okay. Create React app. So we actually executed this command, and I assume it would only work inside this directory, but I don't know. And okay. Success, front end found that. There's a new directory. Yes, there is. So it actually created the front end directory for me. Okay. Well, that's pretty cool. Right. So create React app. Right, because the React app that really is running on the front end. The back end is just a generic server. It's not a React thing. React runs on the front end. By back end, I mean server. By front end, I mean what your browser runs on. You know. Okay. Let's go back here. Okay. Back to our. Oops, that's different. Okay. All right. CD front end. Okay, so we're going to go into that directory. And yarn add prototypes, or no, add prop types. Okay, so I assume it's short for property types or something. Oh no, it's a, well, whatever. It's another package. Okay, so I now have a front end and back end directory. I had that before I did this, but sure. Okay, create chat message JS component in the new front end directory. So I assume what he's trying to say here is create a file called chatmessage.js in the front end directory. We're referring to this as a component. We're here in this directory here. So why don't I see it up here? Let me refresh, maybe. Yeah, there we go, back end, front end. So now in our front end, I want to make a new file. What was it called again? Let's just get rid of that again. Chatmessage.js, okay. So new file. chatmessage.js. All right, now I'm editing that file. Okay, this determines how each single chat message will. All right, so let's see what's going on. Import React from React, okay. Export default, blah, blah, blah. All right. So let's put that in here. So this is pretty clearly a fragment, right? This isn't the actual functioning JavaScript, I suppose, but you couldn't possibly run this on its own. So it's being run by something. Okay, anyhow, okay, chat message.js. Create a chat input.js component. In other words, make a file called chat input.js. So let's do that. All right. And what's going to go in that file? Okay, import React, import prop types. These are the packages we've just installed. I'm going to create a class here that extends component. That's why they're calling it a component rather than a file, okay? Prop types, blah, 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 blah. And then this is the coding. Render can basically return this code. And there's various variables in here, like value equals this state message, etc. Okay, so I see that. Again, this is JavaScript that's being imported into some other JavaScript, which is why we're calling it a component. All right, I'll save that. Control S to save it. All right, let's go back. Okay. So this component receives one property. As input, maybe on submit message. There it is, prop types. Okay. See, like, what's a prop? Has this person done anything to tell us what a prop is? No, nothing. We have to guess. From the chat component we're about to create, which is called when the form is submitted, right? So you have this web page, you click submit, that's going to fire up some JavaScript. Right? Normally it would just send stuff to a server, but in an application like this, it fires up some JavaScript. The JavaScript will run this little script, including these components, to actually send the information to the server. Now create the chat.js component, which will be the center of our chat logic. Okay, so another file. Assuming that these are all files, but I'm pretty sure they are. So, chat.js. And let's look at the code for that. So here we are importing these packages again. A constant. We're defining the web service as the local host. Very good. Let's write WS:// instead of HTTP:// That's interesting. Okay, so chat extends component. So on open, do nothing but log into the console. On message, so when it gets a message, add it to the list of messages. On close, disconnect. Add message, which is called when we add a message. Submit message to send the thing. And render to show stuff. And then we export this whole thing as a component called chat. All right, I get that. Don't know if I could fix it if it was broken, but I get it. Okay, so I've saved that, Control S again, go back here to my instructions. We should be just about ready to run this thing. See, one of the things with these how-to guides, there's two ways of doing them, right? One way is the way they've done it here. They give you a whole bunch of stuff, and then we'll try to run it later. The other way is to try to do it bitwise, where we put some stuff in, we run something to test it. We put some stuff in, we run it to test it. That way, if it breaks, we know where it broke. We might not, if this breaks, we might not know where it broke. Okay. Take a closer look at the chat component. If you haven't already, it creates a new WebSocket instance and adds handlers for messages as well as opening and closing connections. It passes on submit message prop, property or whatever, to our chat input, which actually sends the message to the node backend, right? In addition, it displays a name input, which we will also send to the backend to identify the users. Okay. Update your app.js to include the chat component so it actually renders on screen. Okay, first of all, we have to find app.js. I don't see it here. So, is it up here? BitLab? No. Front end? I don't see it anywhere. Maybe it's in here. Ah, app.js. So, maybe I was supposed to put all of these chat.js, etc. in source, in this source directory. That's typically where stuff like this would go. And I bet you the backend has... No, it doesn't have a source directory, right? Because only this really is a React application. So, okay, here's app.js. Okay. So return. Yeah. Okay. So basically, this just right now, this is a default. It was created automatically. Remember when we ran create React app? This created this. So, but now we're updating, does that mean editing, to include the chat component. So, let's compare what we've got here. Okay, import React from, import logo, import app.css, so we're adding this. Import chat from chat. So we'll add that here. That's probably not going to break anything. So, okay. Now. And then class app. Now, does that replace all of this or add to this? Good question. I'm thinking this replaces the entirety of this. Now, I could be wrong. If I am wrong, it's too late. All right, step three. Seems just you want people to write clearly and they don't write clearly, and then other people wonder why don't I get this. It's not the reader's fault here. It's the writer's fault. They've used something like update your, this sentence, which is completely obscure. Okay. Start, try it out. Start your servers by running yarn start in the front end directory and node app.js in the back end directory, and then point your browser to, okay. Again, they're so unclear. Okay, so what do they want us to do? They want us to, first of all, I'll start a new terminal. All right. So let's go to the, which one was first here? Okay. start from the front end directory. So yarn start, that's a lot like writing npm start. Normally people using Node would use npm, but yarn is sort of like, it steps in and is like, no, I'll do your job for npm, just use yarn and I'll do that job and maybe some extra stuff. All right, let's go to the front end, cd front end. And what was it, yarn start, right? Okay, let's see if that works. And so far so good, okay. Now, big secret here, not gonna tell us. We start a second terminal. See, here's one terminal, here's terminal number two. And we're gonna go to the back end. And what are we going to run? Node app.js. See? Now, this is so confusing. We're really doing the same thing here, right? Yarn start, Node app.js. They're just different ways of doing exactly the same thing. But he's using two completely different syntaxes for this. Indeed, even different applications which end up doing the same thing. Very confusing. Okay, Node app.js, and it throws an error. Cannot find backend app.js. Yeah. So let's go app dot, we know app.js is in that source subdirectory, so let's go into that. Oh, can't find it. Why? But we didn't skip anything. Well, he called it server.js instead of app.js. So let's try, instead of app.js, we'll call it server.js. That might be what he meant. And so far so good. Nothing broke yet. It's not giving us any messages. But it's a really basic, if we look at it, right? It's not supposed to send any messages. It's really basic. So, okay. But it didn't crash, so it's probably running. So, this here is a mistake, right? Unless, you know, somewhere back up here, we were supposed to create server, or create backend yarn add WS. No, because that just, we didn't, the only thing we created was the server.js file. Nope, I think it's just a mistake. Wonder if we see responses, see if anybody said anything in the comments. Okay, just nothing tells us. All right, let's come back here. Let's test it and see if it worked anyways. So, point your browser window to localhost 3000. So, let's copy that. Let's put one of them, paste and go, and can't resolve. So this is in source app.js. So this is in the front end, and it can't resolve this module. Why? Because we followed instructions and put them up here, but app is down in here. So let's take these three that we created and move them into that source directory. Yes, I want to move those files. Okay. And we're just going to close all of these just in case. All right. Now, let's go back here to one node. Same thing, can't resolve. So let's, so you get one of these windows where it's kind of broken. I'll hit Control C, and that gets me back here. And now I'll start it again with yarn start like I did before. You're supposed to be seeing a chat server. No, that is our old alt, okay? Our old app.test. Okay, so let me just kill that. Yes. All right. So let's, I don't know why that didn't end up changed. Import chat from chat. Okay. Let's go back to our article, find app. Okay, here's app.js. Oh, that is. This is it. This is very strange. It imports chat from chat, but doesn't actually show us anything. Because this big thing takes up the whole screen, but you look at the very bottom is our chat. So name Bob, hello, and enter message. There's our chat being displayed. See, we don't need this great big piece of garbage up at the top here. Let me get rid of it. Here's what's interesting, right? This is the bit that's doing all the work. This is the component. The component is called chat.js. There it is. So when I put this component in here, it'll run that script. This is that header. So I'm just going to get rid of this header, and then we'll save this. Compile. Yeah, okay, fine. Now here we go. Right. Now I have my chat without that great big header. So hello. Fred here. Hello, Bob. Now, Bob should have seen this. Bob saw this. And Bob replies to Fred. Fred sees the reply. So, it's working. And now I could do stuff like, for example, I'll just put a header on it and then Control S, and that should restart it for me. Yeah, it's gonna restart the whole thing. And I could add in any other formatting I want. So, all right, so. Reconstructing what's happened here. So I import React, which is a node component. So now my app will extend that component, and it'll basically render this code. In this code, I have chat, which is another component that I've imported from here. We look at chat, right? Chat is going to import two components, chat input and chat message, there they are. And also define a URL for the web service. The state, this is the starting state right now. Suppose I change this from Bob to Steven, right? You see how when it restarts, now the default state was Steven. So I can define some content. Messages, now this is going to be an array of messages in here. I'm not going to try to put some stuff in, but if I wanted to capture something, say from a database or whatever, I could toss it in there in the correct format, of course. I'm not sure. Well, let's test and see. We'll try putting one message in. And no. I'm just messing around now. Failed to compile. So I don't know what the messages in there look like. We'd have to sit down and figure that out. Okay, come back to here. I'll just get rid of these. So it's just an empty array of whatever. It might be, these might actually be objects or whatever. Okay, so first of all, we create the new WebSocket, and then when we first start it up, we don't do anything but connect. And then console log, this is really handy. See, if we're in our application, here we are. Now, I can go inspect element, slightly different than Chrome, but and then console, and this is the console log. Here's the warnings we get. That source map error. That source map error was the when I tried to put in the messages in that array. So, and then here's connected. So when I put in here, console log connected, there's a message that shows up there. Pretty straightforward. Okay, let's clear this log. Okay, so now when I go to restart it again, every time I save it, it restarts. That's one of the nicer features of the way they've got this set up. Control S. All right. So disconnected, shut it down. Now connected, and okay, this is just a warning because see, I'm back in here. I'm importing this, but I'm never using this.
Yeah,
I could use it somewhere if I want it, but I don't want to. Okay, so chat. Once it receives a message, it's going to add it to the list of messages. Once it closes, it'll shut down the connection. Oh, if the server closes, it'll try to reconnect. That's pretty nice. Okay, add message, messages, message, state message. Messages. So, chat input, chat message, default name, comma, message. All right. That should have worked. Oh, I see what I did wrong. Okay, so we'll come back here. Come back to chat. I was trying to put in messages. Okay, so name, comma, message. It should like that. There we go. There's my message. Okay. I don't know why we don't have a name of the sender there, but that might require something more complex. So I don't know. It's still looking for something else in name, but there are my messages anyways. don't know why it's not showing the name. Oh. No, it's not showing anyone's name. So oh well, that goes a bit beyond what was in the article. And I'm not sure exactly how that works. So anyhow, this was a fun little exercise. It's the sort of thing that I do on a regular basis. Just trying to figure out how stuff works. So I figure out part of how it works, and then I move on to the next thing. And I figure out part of how it works, and then I move on to the next thing. And eventually, I acquire knowledge. Okay, if you want to dive into the full code example, you can clone it here and play with it. So let me just show that. So here's the here's their version. Okay, so clone or download. You just copy this. You can do right click copy or just click on that button, right? So if we come back to here, let's create and open a brand new directory. So file, open folder. So we'll call this BitLab 2. So new folder, BitLab 2. And we'll open that. Okay. So now we've got this brand new directory. We'll open up a terminal. Right. So now to clone their repository, git clone, and then this. Now, if this doesn't work, you'll have to install git. But remember how I installed yarn? Pretty much the same thing, right? You go to git, download, install, close your terminal, and then reopen it, and then that should work. So let's clone it in. So now that's doing it, so it's bringing it in. So all of the content here has been copied over. I wonder how close I came to app.js package yarn. Yeah, you see, he called it app.js here. In the article, he called it server.js. See, that's the sort of thing that can get you wrong, you know, lead you astray. Here we are. Okay. So, okay, everything is here. This should actually run. Again, we'd need to start up the two servers, just like before. So, okay. Locals React Chat, LS. Okay, so we'll go into the backend first. And the backend started with, let's recall, the backend start. Don't know why it reloaded that whole page on me. Nothing I did. Yarn, node app.js in the backend. Okay, so let's start up the backend. Cannot find module WS. Let's try npm install. No. All right. It's not actually going to tell me how to run this. So, yeah, so I'll bet you in package.json, back in, all right, dependencies WS, but it hasn't actually been installed. That's what the error was. So, we probably still have to install it. So, now, you see, when you have a GitHub here, if it's not just going to run out of the box, you really should have instructions on how to make it work. I guess the article was the instructions. All right, so let's come back here. All right, so node app.js is the command. And okay, yeah, and it runs silently, very, very silently. All right, and now we'll add another terminal. We're going to the front end. Front end, and that was yarn start, or no, yarn start, okay. And React script is not recognized. So again, we need to do something to make this work. So at the front end, yarn add prop types. See, my understanding of node apps is that this kind of install should be in the installation script. And so when you download something from GitHub, you can just run npm install or node install, I forget which, and it just installs all of this stuff for you. And then you know to start, and it starts. So this is almost there, linking dependencies. I mean, I don't think we need to make again, because there's all of our stuff. I mean, maybe we have to, I don't know. Almost there. All right. Okay, so it's done that. If you're wondering, I'm using the up arrow to cycle back through the things that I typed previously. Yarn start, it's starting. Well, I don't see any messages or anything. Oh, there we go. Starting the server. I mean, it's slow, I think, because it's starting stuff up. All right. That's much better. And we have our chat app running. Where's the name? Oh, name. Oh! Name message. Let's come back into here. Chat.js name Steven, comma message. Hello there. And then we'll put all of this inside these curly brackets, and that makes it good JSON. So the name has a value of Stephen, the message has a value of hello there. Control S. And there it is, the name Stephen, the property hello there. So I could load my JSON in from a, you know, a database or whatever if I wanted to load content that had taken place before I actually signed in. So that's it. That actually went better than I expected it would. Took a little longer than I thought it would. Don't you love how these things, this is a 4-minute article, but we've been closer to an hour. So I hope you enjoyed that. Both of you who watched this video, again, this is what I do day in, day out. No, I do a lot of other things too, but I do a lot of this, and if you're learning this stuff, you'll do a lot of this too. And it takes time, and you know, you iterate, and eventually you learn it. So I'm going to close off this video, and again, I'm Stephen Downs, and it's been nice to have you here with me. Talk to you next time.